Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm looking at the second half of our example that we started with in the last video about charging elephant speeds. We were given a data set. We were told to break this up into five classes. We were told that the minimum value was 19 and the maximum was 32. And from that, we were able to calculate our class width. And then from there, we were able to set up the tally, the frequency, calculate the relative frequency, the cumulative frequency, and then the midpoints and the boundaries. So now we're going to use some of that information to make graphs or look at our elephant data in a different way. The first one I'm looking at is a histogram. In a histogram, remember, the bars of the histogram touch, and the height of the bars is the frequency of the class. And when you're doing this, the classes are along the bottom or horizontal axis, and the frequencies are on the vertical axis. And you can give your some title to this. I called it Charging Elephants Histogram. And when we use the histogram, we use the classes and the frequency. So that's the most basic use of those things that we had before. These were our classes, and these were the frequencies associated with that. So you can see we have 2, 13, 11, 3, and 1. Another kind of chart or graph that we can do is a frequency polygon. Now, a frequency polygon uses the midpoints and the frequencies. And we found the midpoints before, but our midpoints were 20, 23, 26, 29, and 32. And I can go back up here and show you those were our midpoints. So why, when I did this, do I suddenly have 17 and 35? Well, notice that all of these are 3 apart because that's our class width. So I went down 3 and I went up 3 on either end. Because in a frequency polygon, we want our polygon to touch the axis on either end. We don't want it floating. So if we go back one more and go up one more, we know there's 0 at those and 0 at that. And that brings us to that 0 so that it touches. And then when we graph it, we're using the midpoints. And so we have 17, which had 0. Our first real piece of data was 20, where there were 2. 23, where there was 13. 26 with 11, 29 with 3, 32 with 1, and then again, we didn't have any at that point. The polygon touches the axis on either side of the data. Another thing that it asks us to do in the problem, and I'm going to do before I talk about the Ogive, is talk about what, estimate the average speed. Now, if you're given data and it has a range of data, a class of data, and you're asked to find the average, what you want to do is find the midpoint. And we've done that here. So remember, 17 is not really in our data, but we have a midpoint here of 20, 23, 26, 29, and 32. And then we multiply that midpoint by the number, the frequency of that. So our midpoint for the first category was 20, and there was 2, so 20 times 2, and 23 times 13, and 26 times 11, and so forth all the way down. We're going to add all that up. And then the cumulative frequency, remember, is if we add up all the pieces of data, and there were 30 elephants, so there's 30, and you divide by 30, and that gives you the average speed, estimated average speed based on when you have that. So I know in some of the problems that you have to do, they don't just give you one number and ask you to find the average. They give you classes, and so you have to find that midpoint first. So that's something that you need to be able to do. And then the last one graph that I had for this was the Ogive. And the Ogive uses the upper class boundary and the cumulative frequency. So remember, the boundaries are the things that are sort of in between our two classes. So if we go back and look at that, we have between 19, goes to 19 to 21. But what is halfway between 21 and 22? And that's 21.5. What's halfway between 24 and 25? That's 24.5. And so that's how we got those boundaries. And those upper class boundaries are the ones we're going to use for the Ogive. So when you look at our graph, you can see we have 21.5, 24.5, and so forth. Those are our upper class boundaries. And then we just are cumulative here. So remember, if I can put this down a little bit, you can see we started off with 2, and then we had, after 2, we had 13. So down here we had 2, and then we add 13, that's how we get 15. Then we had 11, so we add 11 to 15, that's how we get 26. We're just adding those up. And then the last number should be the number of the total number of our data set, which we had 30 elephants, so it makes sense that we had 30. So then we say, okay, at 21.5 we had 2, and by 24.5 we had 15, and by 27.5 we were up to 26, and then 29, and the very last thing we did was we finally hit 30. So those are three different ways that you could graph, and for different reasons. You're looking for different things there, right? So the thing I would point out again is Ogive uses boundaries and cumulative frequencies. Frequency polygon uses midpoints in frequencies, and histograms use the classes and the frequencies. All right, have a fantastic day.